Listener discretion is advised. Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
Loveline, coast to coast.
Hey, everybody. It's Loveline. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Dr. Drew, board certified physician, addiction medicine specialist. And tonight, Jurassic Five on the show.
Hello, hey. Hello.
What's up? Well, thank
Soup
you.
And
thank
Newmark you. Are both here from the band. And Drew, we both swore that the band was on before.
Yes.
I even had a conversation with a friend of mine on the ride in, and they said, you doing the show alone tonight? And I said, no, Jurassic Five's on tonight.
Old friends.
And they said, the guy said, yeah, how are they? And I'm like, they're decent guys. you went down in my mental notebook as, well, if I don't have any strong thoughts about them, because I think a-hole or nothing. If I think nothing about you, that's good.
Who says a-hole anymore? I love it. Bring it back. I'm going to say it next week.
Oh, you know, the funniest thing is, like, you do enough radio, and you're like, listen, I don't... having a conversation in real life.
I don't give an S
or an F and S about any a-holes, and people are like, hey, you could say the whole word. We're in the car. Right. You understand?
I'm bringing back the word bitchin' personally.
Bitchin', yeah.
Remember bitchin'?
I like to bring, so if you're going to bring bitchin' back, bring boss back, too. Boss.
Boss, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, if there was a car that was jacked up and had some raised white letters on the tires and some Krager mags, like, that car's boss, man. It's the
I'm
boss.
I'm not hip to that one.
You're not hip to boss?
No, I just grew up and it was like, if a car was like that, that was whack.
Oh, wait a minute.
That's what we said. It was whack.
Whack. Boss
yeah.
is good, though, right?
Boss
is good. Yeah,
really?
Wax, is
oh,
wax
okay.
Good?
I know. I bought no. No. Then wow. We said fresh. Then,
fresh.
You know,
is good.
I thought boss meant like.
Hold on.
Not
I'm right.
Good.
Boss
I'm
is
right.
1967.
Oh, yeah. I was nowhere around back then.
Now, how old are you?
Laughing was boss.
31.
31.
Willing, yeah, God willing, 32 in November.
You could still know boss. I don't want to put pressure on you.
Okay,
I'm just saying.
Don't.
All right, but you know what? You could use boss then.
Well, I'll do that.
Take boss. Yeah, yeah.
There was
boss
a lot of boss
you.
Radio. Remember that?
Yeah. And then there's a lot of big boss man on the air and a lot of that kind of stuff. Power Numbers is the name of the CD. It is coming out today.
Yes.
So that means it's out today.
It's out.
And these guys, you guys just did an in-studio?
In-store, North Ridge at Tower Records.
How'd that go?
6,000 people showed up. Can't complain.
Ooh-wee. Bitching.
Yeah. That is bitching, dude.
That's
I
a
brought
lie.
My Redline moped. I brought my Redline and my Diamondback to the in-store at Tower.
Little BMX talk there for you, Drew. 6,000 people. That's nice.
Yeah. Wasn't 6,000 people.
Let's call it 6,000.
Okay, we can do it just for the, you know, for the makeup of it, but it's more like
6,500
or something like that. But it was cool.
That's still,
I'll take it.
That's great, still. Soup. Thanks.
Yeah. Oh, that's why I'm here to help, man.
Should we hear a song to get going?
Why? All right.
Just because you can't seem to get going on the show for one
I can't.
Thing. And secondly, they know who they are.
Drew, really? Is that your job, just to sit there and snipe at me?
No, I'm sorry. You're not feeling good tonight?
I feel like a million bucks.
Okay, all right. Just checking.
Well, I'm just chatting with the band.
Okay. You know,
this is no better or worse interview than I ever do, is it?
It wasn't until you got into that boss and
I thought you started that up.
Maybe I did.
All right. Let's hear a Jurassic 5 song anyway. You want to do that, Anderson?
I just want to hear their music, frankly.
No. Ann says 5 minutes.
All right, 5 minutes.
Yeah, you need to clean it up. You need to cut it up. What do you got to do?
I'm listening right now.
Oh, okay. Oh, Anderson.
It's very early.
See, Anderson's got to listen to it so you guys don't say the S word or the F word or the A in the holes. Jurassic, it wouldn't be a bad name for a band.
A-holes?
A in the holes. Yeah, or something. This guy's name is Andy or something like that. Kilbourne on Thursday night.
Yes.
Yeah. You guys done Kilbourne before?
No. I'm hoping people will be up.
I got to warn you. Oh, yeah, people will watch the show.
You think?
Yeah, but here's the deal when you do, I don't want to give too much away, but when you go in to perform, when a band does Kilbourne, you pre-tape your session.
Yes.
And I don't know if that's good or bad for the band. It's probably better than just squeezing it into the show. You still got the live audience and everything.
Yeah.
And then they roll it in. I don't know why they do it that way, but...
Who knows?
That
who
explains
knows?
Conan for me.
Yeah, but I mean, I kind of knew it was like that, so it really didn't matter. But it's kind of a one-take thing, you know? If
oh, yeah, no, you
once
can't...
Once you do it, that's that, I mean,
it's
so...
It's the same pressure.
Yeah,
crazy
definitely.
Crazy boss bitching pressure on the band. There's no doubt about it. Also, these guys are going to be doing two shows at the House of Blues tomorrow night.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wednesday night out here on Sunset, I'm guessing.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Two shows, 7:30 and 11:30. So, yes. Okay, that's all Jurassic 5 stuff, and we'll hear something off the CD as soon as Anderson cleans up or at least scans the CD and makes sure everything's good and clean for our virgin listeners' ears. Jane?
Yeah, oh, hi.
You're 20. You forgot your made-up name, didn't you?
Right.
No, yeah. I zoned out. I'm tired. I'm sorry.
Right.
What's up, Jane?
Okay, I've been with my boyfriend for about 5 months now, and when we first started dating, he had told me that he'd never gone down on a girl before, right?
Oh, come on. Oh.
And he's 21 years old, and I've tried just about everything. I tried, like, toppings, like, with cream. I suggested after we got out of the shower, figuring I'd be all shower fresh, and he just, he's...
Not into it.
I don't know if he's afraid of it or what, but I can't get him to go down on me.
How old is he?
He's 21.
And he's never done this in his life?
Nope.
And does he have a problem with it on a sort of, I don't know, emotional level? Or is religion prevent him from doing it?
Or is it just personal preference?
I don't know. He's only had two serious girlfriends, and the last one he refers to as man-beast. So I really don't know what the story is. I know it's not religion.
Yeah, but are you asking him to do it, and he's saying no?
Yeah. It's come down to that. I'm like, please.
And then do you ask him why?
Yeah, and he's like, no.
What do you do to him?
Me? I stopped after the last month. I refused to go down on him unless he went down on me. Because I want my reward. It's like a Scooby treat, you know?
Yeah. It's just great when you get in those...
Scooby snacks.
You get in those sexual stalemates with your partner. No BJ, no cunnilingus. All right, no anal, no doggy. Ah, fine. Then you just end up just staring at each other.
There's an important question that hasn't been asked, though. Are you trimmed?
Oh, yeah, I shaved completely.
Oh, well, geez.
Completely.
Ah. Yeah.
Maybe that freaks him out. Yeah, well, you know, hair is a definite deterrent sometimes, so I just had to ask that question.
This guy seems like he's definitely got issues with this, and I'm not sure if you want to be with a guy that you make a request of and he just turns you down. That doesn't seem too...
Empathic, attuned.
Yeah, I mean, guys, you're supposed to take one for the team here.
Yeah. No, that's true.
He feels bad. I mean, like, he keeps saying, I promise, and, like, every time we get down to it, he just kind of... I guess chickens out.
Do you get down to it? Does he get down to it?
Well, like, we'll be fooling around. I'm like, well, you know, before we get started, because it's almost like routine. So I'm like, well, how about we throw in some foreplay? And he's just...
How's his sex?
It's all right. It's kind of getting to be, like, routine. It's always the same thing. And the other day, he actually attempted a different position, and I was very proud of him.
Jane.
It didn't go over too well.
All right.
Why didn't it go over too well?
Got ruptured an eardrum.
It was? Why?
We're a little spastic. I don't know.
Why are you with this guy?
Yeah.
Because he's such a sweetheart. He's really good to me. Yeah.
I don't know. But any guy you make the request, would you perform a little oral on me, and he turns you down each time. Doesn't sound like he's being that great to you. I don't trust this guy, Jane. There's something up with him.
It's even more bizarre to be like, George, I don't know, but I'll do it soon. Here it comes, and then no. What is that? That's bizarre.
I don't know.
It's, hey, you don't like it, you ain't going to do it. I understand that. That's his sort of personal preference, or maybe has some issues around it.
Is he a goofy guy in general?
Yeah.
Yeah, he can't get his game face on, can he?
No.
He doesn't have a game face.
Well, he has it. He's not... putting it anywhere. All right, Jane. I don't know. I'd say dump the guy, but maybe you two are goofy together.
Yeah.
You know, goofy, it's weird. Sex is a weird thing to be goofy about. You got to, even the goofiest guy's got to get his game face on.
You
got to
have your game face on at least one time. Definitely one time.
Right, like even like Soupy Sales, you know, walks into his bedroom, it's like, looking all serious. Hey,
who's
bitch.
That?
I'm going to nail you. I'm going to do too hard, baby. He's got a handful of his wife's hair, and she's here. And that's so funny. I'm not so funny now, am I?
You're going to get it.
You're going to get it.
White Fang.
You're going to get it. What?
You don't remember White Fang?
From what? Soupy Sales? Oh, no. That was
Adam,
a stupid reference. Soupy Sales is 80 years old. Milton Berle. I don't know. The point is you got to be able to get your game face on. And if
you
if you're giggling through it, you're not going to be able to do anything.
You're not gonna have it
and all. You're going to freak the chick out. And right. I guess guys are this way sometimes when they're 17, 16, you know, especially they're kind of goofy guys. I don't know why some guys are just born serious and other guys are jack-offs.
I never, even at 17, when it was time for the game face, I never giggled. I didn't think that was fun because I always wanted the person to come back or at least go out and tell their friends, hey, yeah, if you happen to want to get with him.
Guys attach much humor to that experience.
Yeah, I don't think they do, no, actually.
There's some guys that are sort of perpetually goofy.
Yes.
And they can't do anything.
That's not silly or giggly. That's just goofy.
No, but when they get nervous, they even get more
goofy.
Like, yeah. You know, they're the kind of guys who go to a doctor and the doctor tells them to get in their shorts and they hop up on the table and they start cracking jokes and they get nervous and fidgety. And maybe this is one of these guys.
Could be.
This is just a jag-off.
Enough of him.
Okay, we're done with him. Okay. So I work with a bunch of guys that are this way.
I can tell.
Robert?
Yes,
that's
sir.
What they say, too.
You're 17?
Yeah.
Oh, no. I get my game face on. I look like... Remember they show films of, like, old films of Jack Lambert or Mike Singletary? They could pull up real close on them, middle linebackers.
Yeah, yeah.
Giving that look before the snap.
You can see their breath.
Yeah.
Feet start moving. That's right. Head on a swivel. That's what I look like. Yeah, that's what I start looking like. Mm-hmm.
That turns them on.
I know you're serious.
That's right.
Robert.
I may be blitzing.
What's up?
Robert, yeah.
Right. Last Friday, me and my mom got into an altercation. A bunch of yelling. She kept beating me.
How is she beating you? 17.
Because I was brought up never to hit a woman, and I don't really hit back. I'm usually a pacifist in most altercations.
So she's never beaten you before?
No, she hasn't.
So out of the blue, this all of a sudden happened. Was she loaded?
No, what had happened was me and my brother were in the computer room hanging out with my friend John, and my brother was being a retard, so I gave him one. And I hit him a little harder than I intended to. Yes, granted, I should not have done that. I know. And I got him a little bit harder than I intended to, and he started crying.
How old's your little brother?
He's about 5 years younger than I am. But he's tough. He goes out and he plays football with.
That would be how old? How old is he?
He's 12.
All right.
And
We can never get an answer on this show, even if it's how old's your brother.
Yeah.
It's always we got to do the math. Nope. You could tell us 12. Instead, we got to get the abacus out and figure it out ourselves. Just can't do it.
So she came in the room.
All right. She came into the computer room and she started just hitting on me for like 10 minutes, like right in front of John, and she made. Yeah.
There's a bogus quality to this call, Robert.
Right.
We got to be honest with you.
I'm being perfectly honest here, and she made John leave.
Why do you keep saying John?
Because
that's the friend that was here.
Well, that's
bogus. But why don't you just say she made my friend leave?
Okay, fine. Then she made my friend leave.
Yeah.
And now she's trying to send me to some...
now it really got bogus with that.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry.
All right, hold on a second. I can't figure out.
I know I'm bogus, but just listen for a second.
The dramatic breath.
Yeah.
That sealed it for me. I don't know what is this. Is this there's the 2% of the population, even when they're not telling, even when they're telling truth, sounds like horrible, horrible actor.
Yes.
Keanu Reeves is in that population where even when he's talking conversationally, sounds like he's acting poorly.
Well,
could this be Robert?
There's a mason jar in our future.
All right, Robert, please, if there's a punchline, get to it.
No, there's no punchline. I'm just really nervous right now, and my anxiety's kind of up.
All right, okay.
We kept on arguing throughout the night, and she kept hitting me, and my...
Throughout the night?
Pretty much, yeah. It didn't end until about 1:30.
She beat you for, like,
7 hours?
Six and a half.
It started around 10:30 or so.
She beat you with her fists.
It was off and on. She'd, like, leave me alone
for 3 hours?
Right. And then I would say something she didn't like, and she'd come back and start.
You no good.
And she's never done this before.
No, she's never done this
3 hours of continuous beating.
Where was your dad?
Well,
dad is not around.
Why did you stay in the house? Why did you stay while your mom was beating? Why did you stay for this?
Why? Because my mom wouldn't let me go to my dad. My psychiatrist swears that it's not an option for me to leave to other places when me and my mom get into arguments and fights.
And can't you physically flee when your mom is beating
you? Can't you physically contain her? You're 15?
17.
17?
17. I could, but I'm scared to. I've called into the show before to ask for information for her about degenerative disc disease. I don't know if you guys remember that call or not, but I called in like a couple
Well, times. You're asking the wrong guys because we thought Jurassic Five had been on the show three times before 10 minutes ago.
Yeah. She has degenerative disc disease in her spine.
Right.
And she's taking...
She's pummeling you for 3 hours?
And I don't want to hurt her.
And she's taking Vicodin.
Right, she's taking Vicodin.
I remember this call.
You do?
Yeah.
Yes, and it's overriding. Yeah,
couldn't remember the band not being here, huh?
And now I told you to get that she's a drug addict and that needs to be dealt with. And that's where all this craziness is coming from. I mean, you need to intervene. You got to help get your dad, tell him that her behavior is becoming dangerous now. You have a psychiatrist. That psychiatrist have some obligation to try to intervene here, too. So let's get going here.
She's got a bad back. I mean, how bad a beating can she...
She's the chronic back pain drug addict.
All right. Hey, Robert?
Yes.
Okay. You got a lock for your bedroom door?
Yeah.
You do?
Use it.
Yeah.
Yeah, use it. It's not just for beating off. Although that's the only reason I use mine, but... All right?
All right. Thanks, Adam.
All right. Robert, take care. Still feels so empty and bogus, that call.
I know, but maybe this guy just grew up in a sort of emotionally bankrupt environment, and there's no affect to him. He's like, certain people you talk to, they're like an empty Windex bottle. Yeah. Nothing in them. It's just a little mist comes out of their mouth, but there's nothing. It just doesn't even smell like anything. It smells blue. There's nothing. What is that?
Hmm. Well, it's sometimes it's psychosis. It makes people really seem empty when they're talking.
All right. Jurassic Five in here tonight.
Mom, I'm so mad at you!
You see?
I'm so mad at you, Mom!
That's acting.
Hey, it's Tara Don't Call Me Tara's birthday.
Oh, it is! That's right!
So let's just call her Tara for the rest of the day. In honor of her birthday.
Yeah. Did you bring some pie or something, Ann? Or is that just for my birthday to bring the pie? You didn't bring that bad sheet cake? No. Once it tastes like sheet. Are you ready to go? Oh, you want to play a song?
Yeah.
Yeah. Happy birthday, you're not special. All right. Let's hear something from Jurassic 5. You queued up there, Anderson? Yeah. That's why he said let's play a song. This one's called What's Golden.
Illustrate the paper space off the pens that paint. Then design what habit, National Geographic or magic with tailor-made status and plus flavor that's automatic.
We're not falling, we take it back to the days of yes, y'all in. We're holding on to what's golden.
On the stage, I rage and I'm rolling.
We're not falling, a shot calling. We take it back to the days of yes, y'all in. We're holding on to what's golden.
On the stage, I rage and I'm rolling.
Melancholy, mundane, sauteed, a hot flame. Big rings, fat chains, they all quest for the same. No name, huge fame, strictly new to the thing. We stay true to the game and never bring it to shame. We tight like dreadlocks, a red fox and ripple. We pass participles and smash the artists in you. The saga continues, this I won't get into. Cause there ain't enough bars to hold the drama that we've been through.
Yo, we still the same with a little fame. A little change in the household name, but ain't too much change. We in the game, yo, but not to be vain. I refrain from salt grains to season up my name. We entertain for a mutual gain from close range. Steady aim, my drum at your head to hit the brain. I'm labor ready, roll scholar for the dollar. Work for mines, pay me by the hour.
We're not falling, we take it back to the days of yes, shawling. We're holding on to what's golden.
On the stage, I rage and I'm rolling.
We're not falling, a shot calling. We take it back to the days of yes, shawling. We're holding on to what's golden.
On the stage, I rage and I'm
Yeah, well it's the verbal hermit monster. The word enhancer, sick of phony mobsters controlling the dance floor. I'm in them dark places, catch you when you stark naked. Your heart races as we poke you for your chart spaces. The tart tastes be bringing these hot styles through. Some of you bum a few cheers from shock value. Word power can plow through acres of cornfields. Paragraphs cut like warm steel, perform ill.
Without falling, we take it back to the days of yes, yawning. We're holding on to what's golden.
On the stage, I rage and I'm rolling.
We're not falling, a shot calling. We take it back to the days of yes, yawning. We're holding on to what's golden.
On the stage, I rage and I'm rolling.
Soup and Newmark are both here from yes. Jurassic Five.
Ed McMahon.
Uh-huh.
Power Numbers.
Yeah, it is. Ed McMahon.
Is the name yes. of the is the name of the CD currently out today. We'll take a quick break and then we'll be back with our dear, dear, dear old friends, Jurassic Five.
LoveLine will be right back, so get your problems ready. Ready.
LoveLine is brought to you by Trojan, America's number one condom, the most trusted for over 80 years.
Hey, yo, LoveLine, I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew, everybody. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Jurassic 5 is in studio tonight, but when aren't they in studio, Drew? I guess that's the big question. Newmark and Soup are both here from the band. Power Numbers, name of the CD, out as we speak, came out today. Go out and get it. We'll hear something else off of it in the 11 o'clock hour. And it's back to the phones we go. With Kate. Kate's
Hi.
21. Kate?
Hey.
Hey.
Okay. By the way, you guys are just doing great public service.
Thanks.
You guys. Right. And if I hadn't listened to you, I wouldn't know about the emergency contraceptive.
God bless you.
Good.
So, now, what is that emergency contraceptive? Just for the rest of the
world? It's basically the same as the birth control. You can
right.
take it within 72 hours.
Right.
Of unprotected sex.
God bless you. It doesn't work quite as well, but it does the same thing. Prevents the egg from being released.
Right. Not an abortion pill.
Exactly.
Not the abortion pill. That's right.
That's the point.
So here's my question. I've been dating this guy for like 7 months, and sex has been pretty good. It's been really good, but we just have this problem. It's like the opposite of premature ejaculation. I can't get him off. I could get into the CIA easier.
Then you could get him off.
Exactly.
How often are you guys together?
I see him about 2 or 3 times a week.
Hmm. Is he on any medication?
You know, I was wondering about that, and he hasn't said anything to me, and I don't think he is.
He's not going to say anything unless you ask him.
Yeah.
So, well, you can't get him off through oral sex or...
I can do that way, or, like, give him a hand job.
Yeah.
But just through sex, like, for a while there.
Well, that's getting him off, though, right?
What's that?
I mean, that's getting him off doing doing a BJ, right?
It's through sex that I can't get him off.
Yeah.
And, I mean...
How does it work when you use your hand or your mouth? Does that work okay?
It still takes a little while.
How long?
You know, usually it's after we have sex, so that goes for, like, at least 45 minutes. And by then I'm raw, and then we try to get him off by hand, and he has to finish himself off because I can't do it, and it takes him probably 25 minutes.
Ooh.
Yeah.
All right. Well, wait a minute. A couple of things. First off, I like the we try to get him off stuff.
Well,
I don't know if it's
okay,
royal we or how that works. So we try to get him off. But you said you could get him off through oral sex or a hand job, but that then changed to him doing it himself for 25 minutes, which is to me not the same.
Quite a bit different.
There's a great distinction between those two things.
For about the first 5 months of a relationship, things were going really good, and I could get him off through sex, hand job, blow job, whatever. And then just like the past 2 months, you know, I don't know, it just kind of gradually faded off, and now.
Mm. Yeah. So this is possibly, if he's not on some medication or something, maybe losing some interest?
I guess. Even that, though, to be that far off his game.
And then 25
on his
for
own.
Himself?
It takes a while.
That's an entire sitcom episode?
Exactly.
Is he seeing somebody else?
Even that wouldn't do this. I don't think.
No. 25, that I would like to know the medication he's
on.
Yeah,
I'm with you on that.
Good, man.
I get medication.
I would love to have something happen like that. I mean,
well, you'd have to actually just force it into the opening of your penis to get 25, and like break it off, take a pencil and write, shove it down.
I mean, if I can go extra 25 like that, I think I'll at least try it once.
So I'm thinking medication too. It's such a dramatic change.
Kate, you mean if this guy, if I gave this guy a porn movie and a tub of Jergens, he couldn't finish himself off and under, and I held a pistol to his head. You ever done this, guys?
No.
Who hasn't?
Not the pistol.
Adam.
Russian spoulette, we call it. I hold the pistol to my buddy's head. I give him a porn, give him a tub of Jergens, put some plastic down, and I give him 25 minutes before I pull the trigger. He couldn't do it before I pulled the trigger?
Usually that's because we've had sex before. If he's just jerking off, I don't know.
Well, once you find out about that, I'm curious. And by the way, I bet it's not 25 minutes.
Yeah, it probably seems longer.
I'll tell you something. I went to the gym today, and I did the abdominal stuff.
Yeah.
And I got
this. Did you have an orgasm?
3.
Oof.
Yeah. Trainer was pissed.
Trainer.
Couldn't get it out of his slacks. But I told him, hey, you want to stand that close and hold my feet, you know, you're going to be in for trouble. But anyway, this guy, I did about 7,000 crunches and 10,000, something like that. And I started complaining after a while. And I was like, he was like, it's only been 5 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
And I thought, wow,
yeah,
that's a long time. It seems like I've been on my back all day doing these goddamn sit-ups.
Yeah.
And he said, it's been 5 minutes, in which I replied, you should put your head underwater for 5 minutes to tell me it's just 5 minutes.
Yeah.
But 5 minutes is a long time.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Like, if you're just pounding away having sex, like I was trying to do sit-ups today, and you're just going, five, so these people will go, yeah, we have sex for an hour or half or 25 or whatever. I bet you if he's beating off, 8 minutes is going to feel like eternity. Right. So I don't know that's actually 25.
Imagine
but
just sitting there while he does that for 5 minutes. How uncomfortable.
The person on the receiving end is definitely thinking it's longer
yeah
than what it is.
Yeah,
sure.
The girl's getting humped, thinks it's longer, and the guy's doing the actual sit-up thinks it's longer than the guy who's just standing on his feet. All right, let's I don't know what the answer to that is. Do we know what the answer to that is, Drew?
Find out what medication he's on.
Okay, Jordan?
Yeah, hello?
You're 15?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, hey, I had a question, but first I just want to say you guys rule.
Thank you.
You guys are ground. First time caller, long time listener. I listened for about 2 years.
Wow.
Yeah, and Dr. Drew, you help a lot of people, and I really
whatever.
Help.
Whatever.
All right.
It helped me a lot. And okay, well, I guess my question then.
All right. Thanks.
Good.
Oh, yeah. At my school, like, I'm 15, and I'm 6'5", 6'6", and I'm a really big guy. And
you're 15?
Yeah.
6'5", or 6'6".
How big's your dad?
My dad, 6'3", but on my mom's side, my uncle is almost 7 feet tall.
Whoa, here it comes.
And how much do you weigh?
I weigh 390.
So you're like Peter Pan.
Damn, bitch.
390.
Well, the thing
15.
I'm overweight, but I do work out and I do jog.
Why aren't you playing football?
Really?
I thought about it this year because last year I was a freshman in high school and I didn't want to take it last year because I had some other courses I was trying to get out of the way. And this year I couldn't figure it in, but next year I'm going to do it.
The coach ain't. I'm surprised the coach hasn't darted you
and
thrown
you,
got the natives thrown you back of the truck and dragged you onto the practice field.
No, but the football kids do. They get on me about it all the time. So I'm going to try next year. I'm in JROTC this year.
You're in what?
JROTC.
Junior ROTC.
Yeah.
All right.
And my question was, I heard a call last night about a girl that was like 6'2" or 6'3".
Yeah,
right.
And because you guys do the day late thing, so I just heard it.
Right.
And I don't know how to get. Of course, I'm overweight, of course, but not to a great extent.
Yeah.
And I don't like. I'm scared about, like, I guess average height women.
Yeah.
Because I feel like I might hurt them.
You might.
Well, not just sexually.
I'm gonna love you to death. Come here, baby. Then he squeezes them, and then he starts crying and buries them in a shallow grave. And he sits them up in his room.
I've done
and
a
has,
bad thing, George.
I'm kind of scared, like, not just sexually, but just, I mean, just yeah. the physical relationship.
Yeah.
And so, sure. like, I don't know how to take it because I don't want them to think, like, that I'm hurting them.
All right. Are you, do you date?
No, we're not dating anybody.
Why don't you just start going out with people? They'll be all right.
No, but, like, I feel scared around.
Wait, hold on.
That's the difference of the excuse you're using.
You can't. He's not going to get laid for 5 years.
Really?
You can't do that.
You can't do what? He's going to be 7 feet tall then.
I know. Big guys get punished by chicks.
I wouldn't know.
They don't get laid.
I was always a thin guy, so.
I'm telling you, a guy who's 5'3 and 115 pounds gets laid faster than a guy who's 6'6 and 300 pounds.
But around a college time, all of a sudden the 5'2 to 5'4 women are very interested in those guys. You know,
ironically?
Yes, unironically. So.
All right, I got to talk to Jordan. Jordan?
Yeah.
All right, you're not going to get laid for a long time.
Yeah, I surmise as much.
Yeah, yeah. Don't worry. It ain't going to happen.
Well, but see, I'd still like to just, like, you know, get closer to them anyways without that part entering.
And yeah, that's even awesome. Even that's going to be difficult.
Yeah, I just...
It's tough because you're different, you know?
Yeah.
Guys are goofy even when they're normal size, but guys that are big are extra goofy in high school.
Yeah, I mean, that's just my problem. Like, I just don't feel safe around them. I don't want to, like, you know...
Yeah, but no 15-year-old feels comfortable.
Listen,
yeah,
you can drink out of a mug without crushing it, can't you? Or is it just turn into powder when you laugh? You know, it's like,
oh, man.
You do stuff like, you know, you turn a doorknob, pull the whole door off. I mean, you're like Fred Munster. I mean, Herman. I mean, who's Fred? Oh, Fred Gwynn, yeah.
I haven't had stuff like that happen... Like that, but I've had stuff happen because of my size, have my strength, but not like ripping doors off.
Okay, listen, Jordan, here's what you got to do. You got to be as trim as possible.
Yeah.
Your only shot at tail is being, you know, a trim 325. I mean, you can't be big and bulky.
Yeah.
And a big behemoth. It's never going to work with the ladies.
Well, yeah, see, that's why I was taking JROTC this year because I really like the military. I want to go in there eventually. Mm-hmm.
Beautiful. But you got to limit yourself to eating like 2 cows a day. Maybe like 2 cows and a pig.
One loaf of bread.
That's my
and
problem.
Like 3 loaves of bread,
my
right.
The problem is I can't eat less than like 2,000 calories or I get really bad headaches.
Well, 2,000 calories will be fine.
Yeah, I mean, I can't eat less than that. And
yeah, well, hold it at 2,000. Do it 2,000, get some exercise going, you'll be just fine.
That's right.
You're still growing amazingly. You're 15. You probably need more than 2,000 calories. Exercise, you'll be all right. You'll lose weight that way.
Oh, he's never gonna get laid.
Mm-hmm.
It's never gonna work.
He'll have the last laugh, Monsieur.
He will.
Yeah.
That is pretty scary though. To be 15 and a girl see that, and she wants to talk. He wants to talk to her. I would be scared, and I'm not a girl, and I would be scared of him. I would definitely try to be his friend. That's pretty big at 15. I never knew nobody like that at 15.
I'm telling you, women punish big dudes when they're young. It's all the wusses, all the pipsqueaks. They get the tail. It's tough. And then, they have their day, but that day only lasts like a literal day. It's just one day.
One day, yes.
And then it's back to regular. I think it's like a Wednesday or Thursday usually. Take a little break. Jurassic Five here tonight. Yeah. Power Numbers, name of the CD. We'll be right back.
You know what I'm saying out there?
Adam and Dr. Drew will be right back on LoveLine. 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 LoveLine.
Hey everybody, LoveLine. I'm Adam, that's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Soup and Newmark both here from Jurassic 5.
Hey, hey, hey.
Power Numbers, name of the CD. These guys are going to be at the House of Blues tomorrow night, Wednesday night on Sunset. 2 shows, 7:30 and 11:30. Also, the Kilborn show on Thursday night of this week. All right, CD out. Today. Ready to go here, Drew?
Ready to go.
Let's take a call for the band.
All right.
All right. Let's talk to Hi Boy.
Yeah, what's up?
You're 15. What's up?
Yeah, well, okay, I'm sort of an aspiring turntablist. I can scratch some pretty boss beats, and I just wanted to know,
Boss, who, yeah.
What?
Yeah, go ahead.
I just wanted to know who sort of influenced the Jurassic Five as they were kind of growing up and becoming an aspiring band.
What, DJs?
Yeah, or just whoever. Or
anybody.
Yeah.
Artists.
For myself,
what?
For myself, this is Newmark speaking, by the way.
Okay.
I definitely listened to Mixmaster Ice from UTFO. How old did you say you were?
16.
16, yeah. Well, these are really old school cats. So Mixmaster Ice, Howie T, and then later on Jazzy Jeff and Cash Money and
cool.
You know, a bunch of people. Aladdin, for sure.
Aladdin?
Yeah, DJ Aladdin is, I think, one of the most underrated DJs ever.
Okay, cool. Because, I'm just, looking to learn from, past people who, got big and try and get big myself, so.
Do you have any videotapes?
Videotapes? No. I got mixtapes, though.
What do you do with the videotapes?
There's, like, a how-to kind of situation out there. Beat Junkies, I know, have a how-to out there. I think it's sponsored by Vestex, if I'm not mistaken.
You put the video on and you scratch along to it?
Yeah, well, they show you certain... patterns and pockets you can do with the turntable and the mixer. So that, that's a lot more helpful from when I grew up. I just had to listen to the records, which is actually, I think, better that you might be listening to the records because it makes you listen a little bit. It makes you use your ears more than your eyes. I think it's, I think it's healthy. But there are videotapes. They are helpful.
And you, what do you do? Put weights on the needles so they don't slide around?
A lot of people put like quarters and stuff on there, but it's really the opposite. You really need it. It's when the needle's skipping, you got to take out weight. You got to take off the weight. It means when you see the needle bouncing from side to side in the grooves of the record, you got to take off some weight.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
We were actually raised with records, see?
Yeah.
We actually listened to things on records.
No, I know. And,
records remember rule.
Remember the needle? You'd turn it to 45 or 33.
Oh, yeah.
Needles, yeah.
You remember the whole thing about them saying CDs, when they were first coming out and they were replacing, records. Oh, and they don't skip. Remember that?
Right.
Every bar you go to is j-j-j-j-j-j-j-j,
Yeah, they skip an even more annoying way than records do. Yeah. Oh, my God, and you'd melt them. Like, my dad was so cheap. My dad used to check out records from the library.
Yeah.
That's good.
That was a big move. That was a big Corolla power move. Like,
that's where all the real good records are.
Don't spend the $2 and buy the record. Go check it out. But then my dad would leave them in the car and they would melt.
Yeah. I had a friend who was
melt,
mom
they turn like into a flower.
Yeah, well, yeah, they would turn into some piece of folk art or something. But the problem is they should have worked that out there, right? They had to raise the melting temperature of that just a little bit higher than what a VW Bug would gather in the San Fernando Valley
Things
during the summer.
Things did not work when we were growing up.
Nothing
worked.
You're right. But, here's what I want to say. I think people had more respect for music back then because you had to take care of your record. Like,
definitely.
You'd take the record off, and you'd wipe it down, and you'd hold it, like, under your arm, and you get the sleeve out, you blow it off, and you drop it in. And now you take the CD and just throw it in the back of the car, or you sit on it or something. My idea is, like, CD, to me, is, like, impervious to anything. I just throw it. I throw it on the dash. I pop it out and throw it on the passenger seat.
Undo that.
You'd never do that with the record. You had to have respect for the music back then. That's what I'm saying, Drew. We had respect,
man,
and that's why we're the boss generation.
Liam, 21.
Hello.
Hi.
Oh, damn! I'm on already.
Yeah.
Look at that. Hey. I got a question for Isaac Five before I say my question real quick.
Mm-hmm.
Are you guys coming to Portland soon?
Yeah, we will be in Portland.
Yeah.
Coming up, actually, this month, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, I think like two weeks or so.
Oh, good to hear it. Yeah, I came up from Southern L.A. I'm used to seeing you guys around, but no more.
Southern L.A. We'll be in Southern L.A. too.
Where's Southern L.A.?
What would that be? San Diego?
Yeah, you'd think so, though.
Where would it be?
Where would it be? I don't know.
You said you came up from...
I lived in Pomona, but my friends always, they drive me around. They say, now we're in Southern L.A., so... Go figure.
Pomona would be eastern, way eastern,
yes,
right? Or northern eastern.
All right.
Maybe like Irvine or something.
Yeah.
I had friends out in Irvine. Maybe that's what they're talking about.
All right.
Anyway, all right, my question was...
Never pursued that too much with the friends. We're going to Southern L.A. Good enough for me. And you guys just climbed in the car.
Maybe you're confusing L.A. and California.
No, I'm not confusing those two.
All right, buddy.
It's all good. My question was, I've been taking this girl out for the past, 2.5 weeks. We've been going to movies. I've been, going out downtown, going shopping with her and whatnot, and she keeps repeatedly bringing up her ex-boyfriend, everything about him.
How long have you been dating her?
Just 2 weeks, 2.5 weeks.
Either she is not over this guy for some godforsaken reason, or she's trying to give you a message, which is...
That was my question, because she's got two ex-boyfriends she talks about, and I think I'm getting pushing the friend zone on this one.
How old is she?
That's bad.
She's 20. I'm 21.
Oh, my God.
That is really bad.
Well, let me admit this. I used to make this mistake myself as a lad. I mean, a 20-something-year-old guy, early 20s, going out, talking about other people.
Really?
Yeah.
What?
I think it's
what
a common, common mistake.
What were you thinking?
I don't know. I think
we build yourself up or something.
You're trying to like keep a little distance, and maybe you're trying to show them that you've been around the block too, or they're lucky to have you. It's a way of sort of talking yourself up in a sort of retarded way.
You think she'd be doing that?
Well, I'm saying that this is a mistake. People figure out eventually in relationships just to shut the F up about anything before the day I met you. All that other nonsense, all the bad, the divorces, the abortions, the beatings, the uncles having sex with you in the basement, all that stuff, I don't talk about it anymore. I've never said it.
Not since the day you met me.
Not since the day I met Drew. Less history and more mystery, as I like to say. But when you're 20, 21, you make a lot of mistakes. Now, this is a guy move sometimes, talking about the other lady, especially if you're feeling a little insecure.
Well, that's what I figured, but she's doing it to me now.
I don't think women do it for the same reason.
Yeah, I don't. I don't think it's because she's insecure. I think maybe she, like Dr. Drew said, I think she still thinks about him, man. And what you need to do is you need to ask her to stop doing that, because obviously it's not something that you're digging. So you definitely need to let her know that, hey, either you're gonna go out with me and eat popcorn, or you're gonna go to your ex guys and eat popcorn. But come on, just get it together. It's been 2 weeks, so. If you're not falling hard, you don't have nothing to hold you to each other. So if it don't work, it don't work. But I mean, don't sit there, man, and keep getting beat up. And then, but if you do, you can always listen to our CD and it'll cheer you up.
That's right. Power in numbers. Out as we speak.
Shameless plug.
Yeah, it took a long time to get that.
But no doubt, man. But just let her know that you don't like that, man. I mean, quit, It's only been 2 weeks.
Stuff on her own, though?
Well, wait, let me ask this. What context does she bring these other guys up in?
It doesn't matter. She runs at the mouth like no other. I mean, she'll bring it up. We'll be talking about a movie. She'll bring it up.
Here's what you need to say. You need to go...
Shut up.
Thank you. Just say shut up. Now, it will make people feel stupid if you just say, hey, man, you've been talking about that guy a lot, and you know what? I like you, and it's kind of a distraction. If she doesn't feel really stupid and never bring it up again, then you dump her.
Yeah.
Give her a shot. Give her a chance. You don't have to fly it in her face. Just give it a shout. All right. Want to talk to Raina? Raina?
Hey, guys. What's up?
Hey, you're 23.
I love the show, I got to say.
Good.
And my favorite part is when you question the origin of veal and venison.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I love it.
Maybe we should do that tonight.
Yeah, I think it's one of those nights.
My favorite one ever is they thought that veal was snake and venison was fish.
Yeah.
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 Truly amazing.
Yeah, well, I've always said we have some of the world's dumbest callers on this show.
Well, I hope you don't lump me in with that category.
Well, we'll see about that. We'll see about that, Missy.
Soup Newmark, J5 is my absolute favorite.
Hey, I like you already. I don't think you're dumb at all.
I picked up the new album this morning.
Oh, cool.
Oh, thank you.
Bitchin', been playing it all day.
Yeah,
it's boss. It's
so
boss.
I don't have a DVD player.
Oh, so you can't see the DVD?
I have to wait till I go to work tomorrow.
Oh,
so I'll
okay.
Sneak it in.
Well, then good. Tell your friends about the record, too.
Oh, my friends are well aware.
Great.
We'll be there next weekend. Next Saturday night, you'll be here in Seattle.
Hey, thank you.
Cool. I'll be there with bells on. And, Drew, I have a question for you.
Yep.
How strict do I need to be with the time of day that I'm taking oral birth control?
Within a couple hours.
Couple hours?
Yeah.
So if once a week I'm maybe 5 hours off?
No, no problem.
Excellent.
You're fine.
Excellent. Thanks, guys.
All right.
All right, babe.
Have a great one.
Bye.
Take it with some venison.
Pardon?
Or veal.
Yeah, wash that birth control down with a nice mouthful of veal.
Oh.
All right. We should do that tonight, Troy.
All right.
We'll just get quick. I'll just get quick.
Take a read. Yeah.
Quick read. I get bored doing this show. You know, we do it 5 nights a week. Right. We have to devise ways to keep ourselves entertained, and this is one of the ways we do it. Lewis?
Yeah.
All right. What kind of animal is veal come from, and what kind of animal does venison come from?
I have no clue.
Give us a guess on veal.
I don't know.
Veal, guess.
Yes.
Tiger.
Tiger.
All right, tiger.
And venison?
Rattlesnake.
Rattlesnake. All right. And emu.
What do you mean, emu?
What kind of animal is that?
What kind of animal is that?
I have no clue.
Guess.
Chicken.
Chicken. Sure. All right. See, it just becomes entertainment.
Do another one.
Yeah, okay. Let's, all right, so what do we got? Tiger and rattlesnake? Robin?
Oh, hi. How are you?
All right, good. What kind of animal is veal?
I have no idea.
Guess.
You're 24 years old.
Guess. Go ahead.
Trying to give it a guess.
Cow.
Okay, there we go.
Cow?
How about venison?
What kind of cow?
I have no idea.
Venison?
A black and white spotted one.
Venison.
All right.
And venison?
I'll just say what the last guy said, rattlesnake.
Rattlesnake. All right. Emu or emu? What kind of animal is that?
Oh. I've heard that before, but I'm not quite sure.
You have a guess. What's your guess?
It's not a cat.
What is it?
I'll say what the last guy said, chicken.
Mm. Chicken. That's great. We have a retarded 15-year-old who called before you, and you're just going to go with all his answers. It's fantastic.
What'd you get for number 8?
All right. Yeah. See, this is the problem. She's calling from Glendora. This is the problem with this country of ours right here. Jurassic 5 here. We'll figure out what kind of animal they are. And we're going to continue this all night.
I think it's a Holocaust.
I may go 15 minutes over tonight with this. We'll be back.
Okay, so I know there's nothing wrong with me. So what's up?
So I was like you, and I used to think that these datelines were totally cheesy.
Why can't I meet anybody?
But I tried everything else and thought, what the hell? So I called the dateline and actually met a cool guy.
I called the dateline and I hooked up with some cool people.
Believe it or not, other normal people are out there looking too.
877-889-DATE.
1-800-LOVE-191.
We'll be right back.
Jurassic 5 for you. Phone number for Loveline, 1-800-LOVE-191. Newmark and Soup are both here from Jurassic 5.
Hey.
Power and Numbers, name of the CD, out as we speak. Kilbourne, Thursday night, 2 shows at the, what the hell are they at?
House of Blues.
House of Blues. Yep. That is tomorrow night, Wednesday night.
Is that in South LA?
7:30 and 11:30. All right, where are we? Ready to rock?
Yep.
All right. Jessica?
Hi.
Hey. You've been in college for 2 years.
Well, part-time.
15 years old.
Yeah.
Venison or veal?
Venison? What kind of animal?
Venison, I'm not sure, and I would guess horse.
Horse. Wow. All right. People eat a lot of horse. And veal, what kind of animal?
I'd say a female cow.
Female cow. All right.
Junior college.
All right. What? You've been in college for 2 years.
Yes.
Didn't take basic farm.
Animal husbandry.
Why are you in? Why are you in college? You're 15.
I was homeschooled since I was in second grade, and my mother, who's a non-practicing lawyer, she used all her old college books on me, my brothers, and my sisters. And I sped through them because I was the second youngest, and I kept up with my older brothers and sisters. and I sped through them really quickly.
Well, we can tell by your horse guess that you're a prodigy.
Ha ha.
But wait a second. So are you in junior college?
No, I'm at the University of Minnesota.
Hmm. How do they work you starting college at 13 years of age? Do you take an SAT and an entrance exam and that's it?
No, I wasn't supposed to go to college until I was 15 at the youngest, I think.
Mm-hmm.
But I do exceptionally well on my standardized tests every year.
I'm still wondering, though, it's like, okay, like we talked to this guy before, he was in junior ROTC, right?
Yes.
And he's 15 and he's 7'5" and he's 900 pounds. Yeah. But he still couldn't join the Army until he was 18. I mean, it doesn't matter how tall he is, doesn't matter how big he is, doesn't matter how tough he is or how old he looks, doesn't matter how much ROTC he's had. It's like, you got to be 18.
Right.
We don't have anything like that in college. Like, if you're a super genius, just be 5 years old. You know what I mean?
When I was in college, we had like a 11-year-old.
11-year-old?
Yeah.
I'm going to guess the ethnicity of this kid.
No.
Not Asian?
No.
Not Asian? Oh, because he had a 9-year-old that was Asian. The 11-year-old was what? Really?
And they had to send him to Yale because the computer systems at Amherst couldn't keep up. How crazy is that?
That's the same thing with me, except for I was thrown out of Valley College for being stupid at 19. Other than that, exact same scenario. Exactly. All right. So, Jessica, now the question is... You want to know if it's okay to hang out with the older people?
Well, no. Since I was about, I guess, 14, I've been hanging out with the older crowd and, you know, smoking a little pot here and there and smoking a lot of cigarettes and drinking a little bit. And
sure.
I've pretty
You're in
much...
college. Yeah.
Excuse me?
You're in college. That's what you do.
Yes, but I'm only 15.
Yeah.
And I keep this life totally separate from my family life. And everyone at my job and my family thinks I'm this perfect little angel who doesn't work.
What kind of job do you do?
And so I was just wondering if it's just because of the fact that I'm in college and that I have a tendency towards the older crowd.
What do you mean older?
College age.
Right now I'm seeing a 22-year-old.
Mm.
This is, by the way, my number one argument for not sending the kid to college at 13 or 14 years old.
Does he know you're 15?
Yes.
All right.
Are you sleeping with him?
No.
Okay.
All right. Now I really don't trust this guy. He's 22, he's dating a 15-year-old.
Well, he doesn't know my age. He thinks I'm 20.
Didn't you just say he knew your age?
No, I didn't.
Yes, she did, but she misunderstood. All right, Jessica, you cannot... lead the kind of life that your grade would suggest. I mean, you're fresh sophomore, junior in college or something, but you can't lead that kind of life because chronologically you're only 15.
Right.
That's the message.
You can stay on in college and have a college life later. But now you got to kind of, just for your own health, keep it together.
Yeah.
Not good for you to see a 22-year-old.
When, you know, later on when you're a professor and you've got tenure, like age 19...
I mean, what's weird is the oldest she should be dating are underclassmen.
Who are too old for her.
Well, she could be with a 17, 18-year-old. I mean, it's still weird, but she's...
Nobody's 17 in college, is there?
No,
aren't
18,
they 18?
18, but be that as it may.
18 and 15?
They're freshmen. She's a junior.
I know. Look, don't send your kid to college like that. Unless he's Doogie Howser that Drew went to college with. Plus, it pisses off all the other people that are older and stupider.
Mm-hmm.
Now that I see some snot-nosed 11-year-old who's blowing up the computer with a super brain, and I can't figure out how to get out of the car, lock my keys in the car for the third time this week. That's all I need, some little punk walking around making me feel like an idiot. That's why they don't have... Dude, you want some 11-year-old that's twice as smart as you are? It's going to ruin you. That kid, give him a good ass-kicking. I'll tell you that, Drew. You should have beat the crap out of that kid. Crystal?
Yeah.
You're 17?
I sure am.
What's up? Veal. What kind of animal?
I know this. Veal is baby cow, I believe.
Baby cow. That's good. Venison?
Venison is deer.
Ooh.
Woo.
Yeah.
And you're not even in college.
I am not even in college.
Holocaust, Adam.
See? The Holocaust. What was the Holocaust?
What was the Holocaust?
Yeah.
With the Jews and the...
Yeah, yeah.
Well, when do you want me to explain?
That's good. That's good enough.
That's good?
That's good.
Okay. Yeah, I'm knowledged a little bit.
Yeah, you know what
you're knowledged,
doing.
Yes.
Okay, so my question is...
Great command of language, though.
Excuse me?
Hey, nothing. All right. Go ahead.
You're knowledged. That's boss.
Okay, so my question is, I'm 17, and I have, like, 24/7, I totally think about sex. And this is weird, because I'm not, like, a slutty personality or anything.
Yeah.
And I don't know, and I'm not going to whore around, but I'm such a people person. I love people to death, so I'm always meeting new people, things like this. And it's just, I don't think I could settle down with, like, a boyfriend or anything like that. I'm just, like, going 24/7, like...
Yeah, you're 17.
Is there manic depression in your family?
I don't think so. No.
Yeah. All right.
I mean, like, what should I, like, focus on something else? Or, like, what...
But what about having a relationship so you can sort of get out some of this energy?
What was that?
How about having a relationship for at least a while so you can kind of get out some of this energy?
See, that's what I was thinking. I don't know. I just don't really see myself, like, settling down like that, even if it's temporary. But that's
you're not dating lots of guys, are you?
No, huh?
So
you're not doing anything, right?
Well, here's another thing. I hang out with lots of guys, and I'm just... I know, I don't know, I'm kind of a girly girl in that, you know, I can dress up, I can look cute in a skirt thing, but I really, I'm, like, more comfortable with guys. I have a lot of, you know, more masculine interests, things like that.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. I really feel more comfortable around dudes, and it's just, I think if I went out with a guy, I don't think he'd be real happy about that.
You'd be surprised.
I'm worried about it imposing on that if I go out with some other dude.
Hmm.
Well, you got a lot of reasons why it's not going to work.
Yeah, exactly.
But yet you obsess on guys all day long. What's up? I mean, which is it?
Either I obsess or I don't. Is that what you're asking?
No, you obsess about guys, but you throw all sorts of roadblocks in the way of actually having a relationship.
Yeah, that is odd. You know, maybe it's one of those generic, when I was younger, I liked a guy. It got all weird. I was in high school. I'm still in high school, but...
No.
No.
That's something long before that.
Where's your dad?
Oh, I should have seen this coming. Okay, the dad question. Yeah, I haven't seen him. He died when I was about one, I believe.
Yeesh.
That's it.
So I don't have the male role model.
Okay. There it is.
Well,
you don't need the male role model. It's just your dad was taken away from you.
Yeah.
Now you don't want to get close to a guy. You don't want to risk having a guy
taken
away.
Taken away.
Yeah, that's how it works.
No, that's what it is.
Wow, that just made things a little too simple.
Sorry.
Yeah, well, the hard part is you're not really sort of, that's all operating on a level outside of your sort of day-and-out awareness. But the patterns are all there.
Well, see, that's odd, too, because I get this a little bit from my mom. She's like a therapeutic foster parent. So, I mean, I get all this stuff just pushed down.
What?
Therapeutic foster parent?
Therapeutic foster parent.
Who's your, for other kids?
Yeah, for other kids. I'm not adopted.
Okay,
either.
All right.
Well, you got a bunch of troublemaking teens hanging out at the house?
No. Generally, we take the youngins, and we have, like, one right now.
Did any of them ever do anything to you when you were younger?
Oh, what? No.
Any of those kids, no.
Oh, no.
All right.
All right.
Alrighty, and I just want to say I love the show. You guys completely crack me up.
Thanks.
I love to roll a tangent.
Yeah, you're fine.
Yeah, you are fine.
You don't have any big problems.
But stay open to the possibility of a relationship. You may find it more gratifying than you think.
All right, she's going to ask something else, but...
You're done.
Yeah. I wish all life was this way, where I could go, all right, we've had enough. I wish I could do this with my mom. So
mute. Change channel.
Just had my hold button I could hit. It's like, all right, so dinner, Sunday night about 7:30. Yes, and make sure, and oh, just cut it right there. Now, Mom, we've been on the phone for 3 minutes and 32 seconds. Program director says we need to wrap it up.
I got to move some calls.
Can't even listen to an entire message. You guys go home, you get messages on your phone, and you just figure out who called, but you don't listen to all the stuff they said.
Yeah.
Yep.
And then all you the see time. The person, and they're like, did you bring it? You're like, what? You know, did you get my message? And you're like, you always screw yourself. Yeah, I got your message. So did you bring it?
I usually say I forgot. And then, I can always use, I'm in the studio all day.
Yeah.
It works a lot.
And you're in a band. You know what? People don't expect much out of you.
And I see people and I talk to people all the time. So, no, that works real well with my wife also.
Yeah.
I'm just playing bait.
My mom leaves these long-winded messages and only gets to the good stuff in the last 10 seconds. And that's, I've already dropped off weeks before she gets to that stuff. All right. She's not listening, though. Richard?
Hey, guys. How you doing?
You're 19?
I love you guys.
Good.
I love J5 as well.
Good.
Hey, right thank on. You, man.
Respect, man.
And I kind of have two little issues I called about. My first is that I kind of suffer from chronic migraines, And I was actually going to see J5. I was going to see you guys performing at the UCSD Price Center one night. But I got a migraine. I had to leave, you know, so it was terrible. And, you know, so I just want to ask, Drew, is there any kind of, kind of treatment? Like, I'm taking Maxalt right now.
Mm-hmm. Is that working?
You familiar with that?
Yeah.
Well, I haven't had a migraine for about 9 months, but just last night I had one, and it's pretty debilitating. Like, all right, I'll end up throwing up, you know. And,
all right, if Maxalt are actually helping, that means you have true classic migraines. And in that case, you should try to be on something what's called prophylactic, something that prevents the migraines from coming on, not just something that treats them when they do come on.
If you're throwing up from a migraine, that's a pretty bad migraine, right?
No.
Pretty damn terrible.
No?
It's normal? Very disabling.
Just means bad headache you're throwing up. Doesn't even mean migraine.
They never hear about people vomiting.
Well, how it starts out is like my periphery is completely cut off. You know,
all right. Yeah, you have real true migraines. So yeah, you talk to them about getting on. Yeah, talk to someone about getting on what's called prophylactic treatment, like a beta blocker or a calcium channel blocker, to kind of prevent them from coming on. There's lots of treatment out there.
Hey, Richard.
Your diet as well?
No. Richard, nothing's diet. Nothing. Okay. Nothing. Everyone thinks it is, but nothing. Your zits. Your bad breath, all that stuff. All that stuff you got is nothing. Now it's all genetics. You're cursed by your parents, that's all. Or God, or possibly both. Or maybe God cursed your parents. And anyway, I don't want to get into all those different scenarios, but do you know what veal is?
Veal is undernourished baby calf.
Okay, all right.
Obviously, and the meat is white and unhealthy.
That's right.
And
that's
disgusting.
That's right. You don't eat it, do you?
I mean, I eat healthy, nice beef, but I used to be a vegetarian, so I stay off on the unethical,
right,
you know.
Right. Vegetarian, still with the migraines, though, right?
Yeah, no, it's a hellish life.
I live off corn dogs and jerky. Never had a headache in my life. It's great, isn't it? What about, I actually am trying to invent a corn dog jerky, where I actually dip the jerky in corn batter and deep fry it. But I don't want to talk about it on the air because it's a patent pending kind of situation. Corn jerky, I call it. And what about venison?
Venison is obviously deer, disgusting meat.
Deer, right. Horrible, disgusting deer meat.
It's Satan. And
what meat? Are you a fan of any meat? What about pork? That's a good meat.
I have slipped into the dirty pork realm again.
You do some chicken?
Yeah, oh, yeah. Oh, hell, yeah.
You do chicken.
And fish. I can't live without the Rubio's fish tacos.
Right. No, that's good. But let me ask this. We brought this up before. I know a lot of people that are, they're vegetarian or they're whatever-tarian. They're not really vegan, whatever. They got no problem with fish.
Yeah.
And the whole kind of thing with fish is, well, no, I don't do chicken. I eat fish. And to me, their whole thing is it's a sort of a, you don't want to kill the more majestic or noble of the animals.
Right.
The chicken is much less evolved than a fish.
Probably.
I mean, when you look at one of these 100-pound sea basses, or especially when you start looking at swordfish or something like that, that's a majestic beast. Mm-hmm. I could make a hell of an argument of a swordfish over a chicken. Yep. That's for goddamn sure. So why are you eating the swordfish? It doesn't make sense to me. That's my point. And as far as the headaches or any of that go, the guy was a vegetarian,
I think it is,
nothing.
Is it that animals that can make a connection, like rabbits and things you can connect with as a human, that mammals have a certain ability to connect.
Right.
There's an awareness of an awareness.
Yeah.
Sort of thing. And fish, it's nothing. It's a fish eye. It's nowhere.
It's out of sight.
Yeah. Maybe having tons going on inside, but you can't connect with it.
So plus the thing,
you can't connect with it with your grandiose
anything
ass.
That breathes underwater, it's a game on. I'll eat you. I mean, that can't, there's no connection here. You guys, air kills you? Give me a break. You deserve to be eaten with that kind of horrible attitude. I put you in the air, you die? I put a fan on you, you die? No, I gotta eat you. You're an alien at this point. All right, let's hear something from Jurassic 5, shall we?
Yes.
All right, this one is called A Day. Whoop. Anderson?
A Day at the Races, yeah.
No. He held me up. A Day at the Races.
Music power.
Yo, my method for my musical madness. Move and motivate those with musical talents. We faded in bold print, we holding it down. Lick a shot, hip hop when we in your town. Master blast the sound. Creep the future far from here and now. We'll stop. Release, increase the peace. Bubble with the beat, they feeling the heat in the streets. Now each one, teach one, each one. Young gun on one, listen to the warriors drum. Beating up the block with the ghetto hop to knock and make you wanna crash the spot and the lock explode. Boom. The alpha and omega code with drum rolls and old soul. We uphold and foretold the scores of 6 years ago. Fast flow from G-rap to cool mode. Super syllable, major to the minimal. Every individual bounce to the tempo, yo. Lungs collapse and raps be trapped in. The only way to make it happen, jaw jabbing fast.
Yo, I'm the hot dog, the runner, hottest monologue install. Poetic inserts and yes, y'all. My speech is like holding two blocks apiece. The outreach, that rock police. The super Avenger member 10 of Poseidon Adventure swimmer. Rewrite the Emmy winner, get hype off any printer. And I came to get it, hit it. Like Operation Push, operate the tush. Black octopus, the soul. And in a terry planet patrol, I'm planning my goal. And lo and behold, it's the rubber dog, ready to rock, rock. It don't stop, hops, I knock like the lumberjack, chop, chop. The worst myth, for writing block letters of cursive. Curse with circus, serve the surface. And watch how the brother get over. The fly casting over with the frankincense odor.
Bear witness, don't wear riches to make career bitches. Share pitches when it is, get this, your brains and software glitches. Splatter your brains, leave scattered remains of matter and stains. That'll explain how you was battered and slain. I get rude and go to your show and use your role. Fans to boo and throw you off till you lose your flow. A pro mean that Joe Green when I blow steam. Put your whole team and pause that cold cream. They show laughter when I flow faster. Your whole half to go after her weed from the breeze when I blow past you. I'm dapper plus ghetto and just pedal. When the dust settle, we left in the rubble and the crushed metal. Nurses with hearses, sit like a verse with lit hearses. Spit fire, make it burst a bit. Try me like a Osama, Odama, I'ma cause trauma and homicides when a collide like a kamikaze. Came, baby, walk hard to P-Jets. On streets of Brooklyn, I'm a crew of D-Seps. On streets of L.A., I'm a whole E-set. On tracks with Jurassic, I be the G-Rex. Still that Gucci dressing, still that coochie pressing. My pimp game smooth to get some, I don't use discretion. Top tens do be stressing, I'm explaining it, who's he testing? Physical form or physical forms, leave your ass shaking like a mystical song. Please, now what type of f*** you want? Cause man, the compressor, I mean one lesson. All I want is my niggas all recruiting slimy. All I want is my liver all polluted with Remy. Do it with any, bring it, I face off. Turn you out your league like Jordan was with baseball.
Yeah, yeah. Your majesty, word flash, photography, third class economy, blaze slash your artery. Nerve gas, anatomy, blur past dramatically. Earth's hash, my words flash, packed agility. Never predictability, maneuvers of mind, fully designed. Cause I'm true to the rhyme, we do the sublime. Cracking your backbone, attacking you whack clones. Vernacular, right in exact, capital rap zone. The combat, verbal assault rifle. We fight like Stokely Carmichael. No, we just like you. We broke and ain't no telling what we might do. Ain't no joke. Provoke the right through. We first to see mercy with the king, Asiatic and Percy P. Ain't heard the worst of me. I'm to your chest 3D. Spit venom and burn your body like a STD.
2020 on the next, brother, stepping to me wrong. I mess around and make a eulogy, my theme song. This might seem wrong, but this is a mean song. Crushed like King Kong and just like ping pong. Back and forth, I spit mile and toss. It's time to floss. My verbal affirmation is to always go off. When syllables slide, you'll be enjoying the vibe. Wouldn't consider it pride, it's
J5.
With another deadly melee, camera action, yo, we heavy, aim steady, slash machete, Maserati, engine ready, good and plenty, don't be petty, count the fatty, and we jetty. Off to another city, what we do, our nitty gritty, we wild like Serengeti, Terra down like Stephen Zeddy, get ready for the ride, verbally hang glide, write and stay tied, missions inside, murdering worldwide,
the stage is show night.
Hey, Anderson, what happened to the 10-second sign you normally give me? You gave me the Heil Hitler, you didn't give me the 10 seconds.
Dude, it's just semantics at this point. I'm just trying to get your attention.
I saw your hand go up. I thought you were just rocking out. What that was.
With Hitler style? No.
Well, some guys rock Hitler style. They do Third Reich or Third Rock, as I would call it. Okay. Jurassic Five, everybody. I like that song.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's very nice. Very nice. Very, very, very enjoyable. Did you dig that, Drew?
Yeah. I dug it. Boss.
It's bitching, right?
Yeah, it's boss.
No, that's good. I really did dig that. Power Numbers is the name of the CD. That song, Date the Races. You did, didn't you? We'll take ourselves a quick break, and then when we come back, Drew, who do we speak to?
Johnny's 29.
Oh, he's, man, can't wait.
His boss, used to smoke crack in the bathroom.
Yeah, fantastic. After this.
Hello? Is this LoveLine?
Call 1-800-LOVE-191. Adam and Dr. Drew will be right back.
Hey, yo, LoveLine.
Hey, yo.
Big Boss Show. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Newmark and Soup are both here from Jurassic Five.
What's up?
Power Numbers, name of the CD, out as we speak. Just came out today. All right, when we left off, we're going to speak to Johnny, who's 29. Johnny's boss used to smoke crack in the bathroom.
That is correct.
Yeah. You worried about secondhand smoke danger?
Well, it's like this. It started probably like in April or May, went on for about 3 months before I decided to leave. And it basically, it happened probably about 2 to 3 times a week, sometimes several times a day. And the smoke would go through the, through the vents in the bathroom and pretty much permeate through the entire office.
All right. What's the question?
Wants to know the dangers of secondhand smoke.
You know, I didn't feel anything. I was more irritated than anything else that I'm being subjected to that.
Yeah.
Well, the smoke, as long as the volatilized drug wasn't getting into your system, which you would know of it if it were, then it's just the effects of any other sort of smoke. It's irritation of the airways, that kind
good,
of thing.
Good, good, good.
Yeah, you're fine.
Okay. And also, Jurassic 5, you guys kick ass.
Thank you, man.
Thanks, man.
UTFO, I have not heard that name in a very long time.
Oh, yeah, good. See, you're 29 years old, so you should definitely know who those guys are.
The good old days of KDAY.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
You guys familiar with the Masters of Philadelphia?
Who?
Old funky, I guess classical funky stuff that they did.
No, that's one up on me. I'm not familiar with that.
I'm still interested in the guy smoking the crack in the bathroom smoke blowing through the office.
And everybody just kind of looking the other way.
What kind of work
was this again?
It's actually, ironically enough, it's an attorney service in downtown L.A.
Well, let me ask this.
No, that sounds about right.
Yeah.
The bathroom didn't have a fart fan in it?
You know, it does, but it circulates through the office.
No, not really. It doesn't. They don't pipe the fart fan back into the office. It goes out the building.
The first time I smelt this...
You smelt it coming under the door or whatever.
Well, that's probably the case, but right. You can smell it from anywhere in that place.
All right.
I mean, the first time it happened, I thought it was something electrical burning, so I was freaking out. I called somebody else out to say, you know, what's going on here? The guy recognized the smell as crack.
And then, ass crack.
Yeah.
A veal or venison?
I deal with that ass crack smell at the man show all the time. No, listen. What's wrong with people? First off, bathrooms aren't designed that they don't have intakes for the air conditioning system in the bathroom. They don't suck up the bathroom smell and then spread it out throughout the building. Yeah. They got a fart fan, and the fart fan doesn't come out of the bathroom and start spreading into the boss's office.
In your cubicle.
Yeah. Johnson's blowing mud out of his ass. Oh, yeah, I know. I can smell it's piped in right into my desk. No, it goes up and out the building. I hate guys or guys. I don't like this. These guys are. You're fine. The guy smoking crack is fine. Look, guys smoke crack and have great years in the NFL. Do you know what I mean?
Hmm.
How bad can it be? Huh. I mean, really, think about it.
I've seen it.
Yeah, you've seen it, right?
People doing crack?
They smoke crack. They go have 110 catches that year.
Yeah, it screws people up pretty good.
Well, I don't know. Maybe they'd have 200 catches. Still 100 more catches than you had last year. Robin?
Hi, how are you tonight?
Good. 24?
Yes.
Veal. What kind of animal?
You asked me that earlier.
You were on, I was just getting to you.
She was in the rattlesnake.
Oh, okay, rattlesnake. Still sticking with horse or rattlesnake?
No, I'm actually going with baby calf, I think it was. Mm.
Baby calf.
Yes.
Redundant, but okay. All right, what's up?
Holocaust.
Well, let me just
okay,
get
okay,
to
Holocaust.
The point.
Holocaust. Robin, what's the Holocaust?
It's has something to do with the Jews, right?
What about them?
What about them?
During World War II or something. Right. I don't know.
Chicks know zero about war.
This is fascinating. What happened in World War II? Just
I have no idea.
Well, you got the rattlesnake, right? So how about the Holocaust?
The rattlesnake,
don't get
right?
snotty, but just give us a little thumbnail sketch of World War II.
And the Holocaust role.
Oh, I don't know.
Who was fighting in World War II?
Just about everybody.
All right.
Who was on which side?
What do you mean by who was on which side?
Who was on our side, the American side?
Oh, I have no idea.
Yeah.
Who was on the other side?
Everybody except the Germans.
Who was on the bad side?
Germans, you said?
The Germans.
All right.
Is that it?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. Right. Germans bombed Pearl Harbor?
No, they didn't. Japan did.
All right. Now we got it.
L.A. Unified School District?
Did you go to L.A. Unified School District?
No, I didn't, actually.
Where'd you go?
I went to an out-of-state correctional facility in Louisiana.
Correctional facility?
For what? Yeah. What we've been corrected for?
Well, my parents, I guess they thought that I'm adopted, and because of all the abuse I suffered as a kid, I was very sexually promiscuous as a young kid. And so they thought that the answers to their problems were to ship me off to a correctional facility in Louisiana for 10 years of my life.
10 years?
Wow.
Yeah.
How old were you when you were acting out sexually?
I was 10 years old.
Oh, my God.
Mm. Mm.
So
you were really doing stuff that was harmful to yourself.
Yeah, I was.
So they weren't shipping you anywhere. They were just trying to keep you corralled, contained.
Yeah. The place that they sent me to, they didn't get any information on this place.
How's that going now? How are you doing now?
Oh, right now I'm doing great. I work with the mentally disabled. I work through the regional center, and I've gotten my life straightened out and everything. I'm just actually having these really weird flashbacks
of the abuse.
Yeah.
You need to work on
which
that.
Abuse?
Physical and sexual.
At whose hands?
Whose hands?
Who did it?
Oh, at the hands. Well, okay, these people who own this correctional facility, it wasn't state licensed. There were two Southern Independent Fundamental Baptists, and they believed the Bible down to the nitty gritty, like the King James Version, and they believed everything that was in the Bible, and they went accordingly to that. They believed in Deuteronomy it says, spare the rod, spoil the child. And they believed, but by beating a child, that you would keep them from going to hell. And stuff like that.
All right. That's bad. Now what? Are you getting any therapy or anything?
No, I haven't gotten any therapy. Actually, when I'd gotten out, I was so traumatized by it. I guess I just told myself I'm just going to forget about it and never remember it again. And now it's little stuff. I was taking a bath the other day, shaving, and I cut my legs, and all of a sudden I'm in a totally different place, and I have cuts all over my body, and the water's full of blood going down the drain. It was just really, really weird.
That's what you
flash back.
Yeah.
Did that happen to you when you were in school?
Yeah, I guess it did. I mean, I can't really pinpoint what it came from.
Right.
How long did it take you before you came out of that?
Still in it.
My friend said I was in the shower for 3 hours, and I only remember taking a 5-minute shower.
Oh, so you have? Do you ever do you dissociate in other ways? You move clothing around and don't remember it and that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Where was your friend, by the way?
Oh, my friend was just in the living room playing video games.
So let me say, after one of my buddies in the shower for 2.5 hours, there's a, hey, you about done beating off? Because the movie's starting. I just assume they're beating off he's going for the handshake or something in there.
Yeah.
Yeah, they didn't come get you, huh?
Robin, do you have multiple personality, you think?
I don't think so. I feel sometimes people are coming after me. I'm very
paranoid.
Very, how would you say?
Paranoid?
I don't know.
Paranoid.
I'm paranoid, but I think it's because of the fact that these people brainwashed me.
No, I understand you had some serious, serious trauma.
All right, baby. Therapy.
Yeah,
huh?
And this post-traumatic stress disorder with dissociation, this is all serious stuff. And you need some help for a long time to decrease the reliance that you have upon dissociation as a way of dealing with overwhelming feelings. It's going to interfere with your relationships. You're going to create trauma in your life accidentally and reenacting some of this stuff. And it's time to stop.
Yeah.
Get some treatment. Listen, you work with them mentally ill. You understand some of that, those issues.
Yeah. I can't stand these parents. Not the ones who sent her off to the school, but the ones who abused her in the first place and got her into the adoption program. Mm. It's just pathetic. You screw around with your kid and that's it. They never forget. They just walk around, sexually abuse, physically abuse. Whatever you do to your kid, that's it. Especially a little girl, scrambled.
Oof.
scrambled her whole life. 3 hour showers. I barely even take showers. Just want to see how long it would go before someone piped up.
I was kind of enjoying that.
Yeah, it's kind of nice.
Let's do it again.
All right, ready? Do I have to hold my breath?
That's a good guess.
Yeah.
They cooperate. It's good. I like that.
Let's do it one more time. So I'll take a breath, see how long we can hold our breath.
What the hell are you doing?
You know what it is, Drew? We're like prisoners who get sent down to the cooler in those World War II movies. We have to find ways to entertain ourselves.
That's it.
We gotta get a TV going in here or something, right?
Something to make us behave. Yeah. So we come dressed at least and comb our hair. And...
You mean get the show on TV? Yeah. Or we should just do something like, it's to me, it's like this is a slumber party gone bad. You know, we shut the lights, we get flashlights, we bounce them off the ceiling, we have little Star Wars things.
No one ever
goes
to sleep.
No. All right. Rhonda?
Yes, hi.
You're 36.
Yes.
Your boyfriend was drugged, you say?
I think he was drugged. He was out at a bar the other night, and he came home, and within a half an hour, he called me on the phone and said everything in his apartment was shrunken. It looked microscopic. I've looked at every drug up on the computer, GHB, Rufinol. I don't see anything with a side effect like that.
And well, hallucinogenics.
Our knowledge base, maybe you could tell me what type of drug would do something.
Did he call you and say he was freaking out?
He did, and he's not on any medications. He wasn't taking anything. He had some drinks that night out with his friends.
Well, there are no drugs that would typically do that. Hallucinogenics can do almost anything perceptually.
Yeah, so whatever you want.
Possibly hallucinogenic.
That's the beauty of them.
Possibly seizure or something neurologic causing these symptoms?
Not to my knowledge.
I understand, not to your knowledge. But
yeah.
I understand, but that's a possibility. And the other would be some sort of psychiatric symptom, but I don't think he...
Nothing really specifically
comes to mind with that.
Yeah.
Is he all right now?
Yeah, within 20 minutes, he was fine. I kept him on the phone. I wasn't with him, and he couldn't reach anyone else in the area.
Within 20 minutes?
Within about 20 minutes.
They ain't acid or mushrooms or anything.
I can't think of anything.
Why would someone want to drug him? He's a dude.
Well, you know,
only drug women.
A lot of people do it out at the bars. I mean, I'm from the Fort Lauderdale area, and they had a big problem with that there.
Drugging? Drugging ugly guys and sending them home alone?
Guys and girls.
There's an epidemic in Fort Lauderdale?
It had been. Actually, a few people were arrested for it there.
Not guys. Not drugging guys.
Guys and girls.
No, listen. Hey, you see that fat guy with his ass crack hanging out at the end of the bar drinking the Bud Talls? Let's slip something into his drink and then just go home.
No, it doesn't happen.
No, doesn't happen. I don't know what this guy, I don't know what happened to this guy.
Holocaust, ask her.
Does he take drugs?
No.
I mean, has he taken drugs before?
No.
So you can't drug me because I know immediately what drug you gave me.
Yeah.
A vast experience.
Guys are not drugged in date rape scenarios, in bars.
Even a mixed bar?
What do you mean mixed?
She means there's Irish there.
Yeah.
A mixed bar, I see.
Straight, so just a mixed bar.
I see. He's going into like bisexual bars?
Yeah, he was out with a group of friends, and he doesn't typically go there. Ah. But that was the only thing he could figure out, is maybe someone put something in his drink, and I hadn't.
He just hyperventilated. Maybe a little radon in the apartment or something. Maybe the pilot light blew out on the gas heater. He got a little gas in there.
I don't know.
He's all right. All right, Rhonda. Veal, what kind of animal?
What kind of animal? I picked up late, so I don't know where you're coming from.
You know what kind of animal a veal is?
Oh, a baby lamb.
Baby lamb. Yeah. And we're right on board now. And what about venison?
That would be a adult deer.
Adult deer.
Holocaust?
Holocaust was horrible. Assassination of the Jews. There's a whole museum in Washington.
That's right.
The Holocaust Memorial. Horrible.
Good times, baby. All right, just checking on you.
Thank you.
All right, sweet pea. You take care of yourself.
Have a good night. Take
good
care.
Times.
Bye-bye.
Going out to the mixed bar. They got bi bars? Or aren't all bars bi?
He need to stay out of those bars. If he miniature front. I really wish he would have went into that miniature front. I would like to know if he tried to sit on it.
Yeah. Chair went right up his ass.
I want to break it.
That ought to have been pretty good to see.
He came home. Oh, fee-fi-fo-fum. He knew he was in trouble because he whacked his head on the door jamb as soon as he walked through it. Maybe he grew.
Ooh.
That's the angle.
That's it.
All right, Jurassic 5 here tonight. Take a quick break. Be right back.
LoveLine. 1-800-LOVE-191. Back in a minute.
Loveline, everybody. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. New Mark and Super both in here from Jurassic 5. Name of the CD, Power Numbers. And it is out as we speak. It came out today. Let's take a question for Jurassic 5 from Scott. Scott, 16.
Hey. How's it going?
All
right, Jurassic 5.
Yeah,
big fan.
Yes.
I heard you guys first time on Quality Control.
Yeah, love it.
I was curious, Jurassic 5, how'd you get the name? There's six people.
Actually, it was a joke. It was like a joke. One of the guys, mother of his kid, was actually making a joke of us. And it's a group back in the day called the Fantastic Five. And she was like, you guys think you sound like them, but you sound more like the Jurassic Five. And we was like, hey, that's it. And we gave her $10 for the... You know, the rights of the name. She was happy. She got a six pack, and we got Jurassic 5.
Right on. All right.
It's a good name.
Thank
you. Yeah, words are weird. This one works. Yeah. It worked so good on us, we thought you were on the show a couple times.
But you got to say Jurassic 5. Do not say Jurassic Park. I don't want Spielberg taking a chunk out of our ass.
Yeah, that's going to suck.
Anything else, Scott?
Hope to see you guys out in Southern California.
Definitely.
And I like venison.
Oh, good times.
Holocaust?
Great times.
You know what the Holocaust is?
Well, yes, I do.
Good times. I take his word for it.
He sounded alert, alert enough.
A lot of bravado. Hey, Mark?
Yeah.
You're 17?
Yeah, I was wondering if the listeners to your show have been consistently dumb over the past few years, or if they've been getting progressively worse.
I'd say they're
fairly consistent.
They try to stay three steps behind society. So wherever society's going, they're lagging just a little bit. So if society's heading into the crapper, they're usually there to meet them.
So let's see what Mark does with the questions.
Well, Mark's got to have all the answers.
Well, some of them.
Veal?
Veal is baby cow.
All right. Venison?
Deer meat.
Huh. Emu?
It's a flightless bird.
Ooh.
Kind of like an ostrich.
Flightless. Nice. I like that.
Yeah.
It sucked being a flightless bird. I got to imagine other birds like crapping on you and laughing on you. I mean, why be bothered being a bird? You know, I guess they run like 80 miles an hour. Okay. And what else? Oh, Holocaust.
Genocide of the Jews by the Nazis.
Good times.
World War II.
Good times. Wow. You're like an atlas. Yeah.
You should ask people like what Auschwitz was and everything.
Well, but it's...
Or is that too hard?
That's a little advanced for them because they're having difficulty with the Holocaust part, too.
How about the acronym SCUBA, then?
Oh, SCUBA.
What does it mean?
Yeah, Drew?
Self-contained underwater breathing apparatus.
Oh!
Yes.
Who invented it?
Mr. SCUBA. Actually, Jacuzzi. I think Jacuzzi invented it.
I don't know.
It's somebody's named Jacuzzi.
Jacques Cousteau, you say, Mark?
Yeah, wasn't he?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Although, it seemed like Jacques may have sort of perfected it, but it seems like this idea was around before Jacques was, although...
Well, it was diving bells, but they weren't self-contained.
This is an
independent unit.
I got another question. James.
Yeah.
16, who's Jacques Cousteau?
I have no idea.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, see?
Well, that's not our guy.
No, I'm asking. I'm asking another caller.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. All right. Yep. All right, James. Go ahead.
My question was, a couple weeks ago, I had sex with this girl. It was protected sex.
Mm-hmm. And then after we had sex, she told me that she had got chlamydia from some guy, and she had got it cured, like, 2 weeks before we had sex.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I know of her, like, still having the chances of. She said she got cured, like, a week.
Yeah, you only need to take a single dose of an antibiotic will pretty much clear it up. Did you get any? Did you have any symptoms?
No, I just want to know. Cause I'm going to get tested like in a week.
But you've had no symptoms.
No, not.
All right, you should be fine.
I just want to like the chances of getting it or anything.
There's always a chance that it wasn't completely eradicated, but that would be pretty unusual.
All right, it'd be less if you knew who Jacques Cousteau is.
Yeah, sure.
Brent.
Yeah.
You're 17.
Yes.
You just moved from New York to Orange County?
Yep.
And now you're having trouble getting chicks?
Yeah.
There's a lot of hot chicks in Orange County.
Especially with the command of the gift of gab that he has.
Yeah.
It's just been like, since I came out here, I had like no chicks, so I've been getting like more trouble. And I'm on probation because of it.
What are you on probation for?
Yeah, because I got in trouble with my dad because I'm home all the time.
Okay. Well, it's hard to pick up chicks in OC when you sound like Joe Pesci. but here's the deal, too. And let me just put this little warning out to all of you transplanted New Yorkers. You're 17 now, right?
Yes.
And you moved out here just recently.
Yes.
Now, here's all I'm saying. You can talk about New York. You can love New York. Be a big Yankees or Mets fan, whatever you want. But when I run into you and you're 54 years old, drop the New York. You know, when you've been in Los Angeles five times as long as you've been in New York, eventually drop it.
Yeah.
Everyone's tired of that. You know, you talk to these guys, like, hey, that wouldn't have flown back in my neighborhood and all that stuff. It's like, you moved when you were eight. You're 53 years old now. You've been living in North Hollywood for 47 years. Right. You understand? Drop the New York. It's not you. Now, you got another 20 years of talking about New York, but once you get to like 40 something, that's it. Enough of the old New York. Oh, the pizza. Oh, you can't get pizza. No. And eventually, it's just move the F back then. If you can't get the pizza, nobody knows what they're doing here and everything sucks. Please. LA's got to be the number one town where every a-hole from the rest of the country moves here and just talks about how much this town sucks. It's like, how stupid are you? You moved here. Stay in your beloved wherever you came from.
All right.
All right, thanks, Brent. Hey, Brent.
My question is...
Yeah, oh, yeah, yeah. Like, sorry, buddy. A lot of energy
like
built up.
I'm straightforward with the chicks up in New York, and they, like, did...
He did what?
I was, like, straight up forward with the...
Straightforward, right, right.
With the chicks in New York.
Right.
And I'm straightforward with the chicks out here, they take offense to it.
You gotta have a little finesse out here.
Yep.
I know in New York,
it's
pretty much just hit him with the ether rag and drag him to the back of the van. That's considered a gentleman over there.
Well, I liked, I was trying to find out exactly, he said, because he couldn't get chicks, he was getting into trouble more. I mean, I think he just better get you a job, man.
There you
I mean,
go.
Don't.
Get a
good
job.
Answer.
Yo, yeah, you getting in trouble because you can't get chicks? Come on now.
Get a job and... You pull off that Yankees cap right when you get to your 50s.
And then also, and if you're getting in trouble, if you go to jail, guess what? You still won't get no chicks. So you better get a job, man.
We'll be right back.
All right, guys, here's the deal.
Dateline.
You're looking to hook up, sick of wasting time with the wrong person?
Dateline.
One call is all you need to make. Call the Dateline. 877-889-DATE.
Call the Dateline.
Well, that's the show, everybody. I want to thank Jurassic Five for coming in here tonight.
Thanks for having
us, man.
Thank Soup and Newmark and Power Numbers. Name of the CD out today. Go out and get that. See the guys on Kilborn. Wheelchair.
Foster Brooks. Here we go.
And that's good. Tomorrow's night question is who's Foster Brooks?
All right. Good. There'll be a zero response rate on that one.
Zero. All right. So until next time, this is Adam Kroller for Dr. Drew saying mahalo. If there was a car that was jacked up and had some race white letters on the tires and some Krager mags, like, that car's boss, man. It's the
I'm
boss.
I'm not hip to that one.
You're not hip to boss?
No, I just grew up and it was like, if a car was like that, I was whack.
This has been Loveline. The opinions expressed on this show are not necessarily those of the staff, management, sponsors, or this station. The producer for Loveline is Ann Wilkins Engel. Loveline is a presentation of Westwood One Entertainment.